Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I want to talk about GitHub integration with Microsoft Fabric. That's right, GitHub is here. I've been waiting for this. As always, if you like this video, be sure to hit that like button, and if it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Now, I did a video not too long ago, talking about Git integration with Microsoft Fabric, and that was centered around Azure DevOps, but since then, GitHub has become available as well. Back when I was on the docs team for Power BI, everything was done with GitHub, so that was my introduction into Git. All right, enough all this talking. You know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's jump over to my machine. As always, I'll have links down in the description below to documentation on how to do this, but let's walk through a couple things. So I've got a workspace here, and this workspace is currently not set up for Git integration, but if we come down into Git integration, we can see we've got Azure DevOps and we've got GitHub. Cool. So if I come into GitHub, it'll say, whoa, there aren't any accounts. So we need to connect an account with GitHub itself. We can give it a display name. So let's give it Guy in a Cube GitHub. It's asking for a personal access token. So we're going to have to go over to GitHub to get that. And then it also wants the repository URL. So let's jump over to GitHub. This is our repo that we're actually going to want to sync. And one thing we want to do here is we want to come down to Guy in a Cube settings. And then all the way down below, you'll see developer settings. In here, we can go to personal access tokens and then fine grain tokens. I do have a fabric token that's here, but let's get rid of that. And we're gonna create a new one. So we're gonna generate a new token. We'll give it a name. Expiration, 30 days, you can go 90 days or you can do a custom. So that's up to you in terms of how often you wanna update this. Give it a good description. Resource owner is gonna be me. In here, I'm gonna do only select repositories. So I'm trying to go with the least privileged items. I wanna be specific with what this key has access to. I don't wanna give it like everything, right? So in this case, I just want it for this one repo. So we'll come down and we'll choose my report repo that we showed before. That's good. Now you have to specify permissions. And from the documentation's perspective, it said that all you really need to do here is the contents permission. And if you want to be able to actually commit back into the repo, you're going to need read and write. If you just want to pull and get the contents and you're not going to push back into GitHub, then you would only need read. You've maybe had a policy where you're going to do any editing and whatnot outside of Microsoft Fabric, and you only want it to pull in those changes that your developers are doing. So you don't want Fabric actually writing back. So if changes are made, you don't want that going back to GitHub. That may be a scenario. But if you want to push back and like add in a commit and make changes and whatnot, then leverage the read and write access. For our case, we're going to go to read and write, and then that is everything I need. Generate token. I'm going to go and copy this token, come back, add that in, and then we'll get the URL for the repo itself. So let's go back to report repo. We'll grab the URL and we'll add that in and we'll say add. This connection is actually stored similarly to how your connections would for gateways. I wasn't aware that that was a thing, but here we go. Under connections, if I scroll down, we'll see now that this GIEC GitHub is here. So this is the GitHub source control information. So if you need to go and update that, maybe that access token changed and you want to update the access token, this is how you would do that. All right. Let's go back to our workspace. We'll come back into workspace settings, go back to Git integration. Our account is set. So let's go ahead and connect. And here we're gonna choose a branch. So I have a branch in there called AdventureWorks. There is a folder there. So I did Project Yoda. If you just go to the root of the GitHub repo, you would think that it would add the folder into the workspace and then add all the items under the folder. It's not gonna pull anything. If there is a specific folder where the content is, in my case, it's Project Yoda, you want to specify that folder so that it actually pulls and syncs those items correctly. So we'll say connect and sync. Then our content is synced because we got the right folder. Now, one thing to be aware of is it pulled in the definition of the model. The data is not actually there. So if I go into the report, there's no data. So we got to go and make sure that this is updated correctly. So let me go ahead and we'll go to settings. And so I'll come in here and I'll set up the connections. We'll apply. and then we'll refresh the semantic model. All right, semantic model is done refreshing. If we go back into the report, you'll be like, no, it's blank. Well, just refresh the report so it gets the data and bam. Well, that's great, but I wanna make changes. I wanna see how this works. I did this in the previous video where I showed how you can do this between a developer working on their machine and also changes made in the web. So let's do that with GitHub because it works almost the same way. You can actually do this directly from the Git command line if you've got the right URLs. In terms of working with GitHub, I set up the repo locally from a clone perspective using GitHub Desktop. And then after that, I'm a terminal guy. I know a lot of people that just use GitHub Desktop and they don't use the terminal at all. So I'm gonna come to GitHub Desktop. You'll see I've only got demo files locally. So let's go ahead and we're gonna clone a repository. I wanna clone my report repo. It's gonna go into my D drive source folder and then into report repo. Cool, let's clone it. Bam, it's there. So now if I come into Explorer, we'll see that in our source drive, we've got report repo. It's got the folder project Yoda. Everything is good. And then if we open up a terminal, let's go to the D drive. We'll go into the source drive, do a directory. We can see report demo is there. And now we know that we have Git integration because we're in the main branch. Cool. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a change locally on my machine. And then we'll see if that gets picked up with Microsoft Fabric. I've got a branch in there called AdventureWorks. That's what the workspace is aligned to. So let's go into that. When I go to make changes, I always start with a pull because I want to make sure that I've got the latest thing because I don't know what other people have done. My number one goal is to avoid a merge conflict because nobody likes that. Git pull. Boom, everything's up to date, of course, because I just cloned the repo, right? So that makes sense. So now let's go in. We'll go into Project Yoda. We'll open up the report. Again, I had to do a refresh because the data wasn't there. Cool. So let's create a new page and we'll go ahead and we'll just pull in some data here. The data and the visual is not actually important. We just want to make sure that a change is being reflected. So we've got our item here. We're going to go ahead and save, and then I'm going to close the report file. Now, if we do git status, what I've got here is that the changes I just made are local on my machine. They are not reflected in GitHub yet. So I've got to commit this locally. The push is going to send it up to GitHub. And then on the Microsoft Fabric side, we'll see that there's a change and then it will do a pull to pull in those changes. So let's go ahead and do git add, and then we'll do a commit m add report page. So now I've got the commit. So now I have to push this to GitHub itself. So now this is reflected in GitHub. If I come into GitHub, it doesn't show anything because this is on main. So if I switch to AdventureWorks repo, there we go. 1 minute ago, there was a change. So this is now up in GitHub. So if we come back to Fabric, we'll see, hey, there's a pending update, right? Because now I've got to pull that change into Microsoft Fabric. So this report doesn't reflect that page yet. So if we come in, it's just got the one overview page. We don't have the new page. So let's go in and we'll go and get the update. All right, update all. And now we're synced. If we come into the report, we'll see new page here and those changes are reflected. Amazing. So we went from my local machine up to GitHub into Microsoft Fabric. So let's go the other way, right? I don't like that new page. It looks like a page Patrick would have done. So let's get rid of that. Come into edit. We'll get rid of the new page and then we'll reset the default page to overview. We'll come to file and we'll save that. We've now made a change in Microsoft Fabric. It says it's uncommitted, so it only exists in Microsoft Fabric. So let's go into source control. And now we'll have to actually do a commit. Remove the report page. We'll include the AdventureWorks report. And now we'll do the commit. All right. So now Microsoft Fabric has pushed this back to GitHub. And if we come back to GitHub, we'll see that it was just done. And we've got our remove report page commit there. And so now if we come back into our local items, let's clear this. One thing I've seen is that when you do the git status piece, it doesn't show it right away. This could be just a timing thing where things are cached for a little bit for performance reasons. One thing you can do to try this is switch a branch and then come back. Although sometimes that doesn't pick it up either. And so sometimes maybe you just wait 5 minutes and then it would show up. Normally you're probably not doing this as quickly as I am. And so you'll come in the morning, there'll be changes, you get those. If you want to see it reflected in the UI of the terminal. If not, if you just know it is and you follow my practice of, look, I'm going to make a change, I'm going to do a pull. So let's go do that. So I do a pull and bam, there you see those changes. And so now those changes are reflected locally. And if I go back in, open the report again, you'll see that that new page is now gone. So those changes are reflected locally across the board, which is great. So now I've got changes that are in my branch from a GitHub perspective. I want to go back into main and we need to do a pull request because the changes are in my AdventureWorks branch, but they're not reflected in my main branch and I want to catch up main. So on the GitHub side, I'm just going to do a pull request. So if I go to pull request, we'll say new pull request. We'll do main and we'll do AdventureWorks. Everything looks good. Let's create a pull request. I always do a little emoji so that I can always spot my pull requests. Create the pull request. Everything's good. And then we'll merge it. So we're merging the changes from the AdventureWorks branch into main. We'll confirm the merge. Everything's good. We're in main now and we'll see that everything is reflected accordingly. And if we come into main, and we do a pull, it's showing fast forwarding because it's just moving to the latest commit that was in the other branch. So now everything is set, right? So I integrated with GitHub. I've made changes both on desktop and the web, and things are flowing correctly. If you have multiple developers, Git integration is an amazing thing. The other thing of note that I saw in the documentation is that it looks like it does cover GitHub Enterprise. Check it out, see if it works. I haven't played with GitHub Enterprise myself, so that might be something I have to go do. Let me know in the comments if you want me to go give that a try and show how that gets set up. That'd be an adventure for me. And it is AdventureWorks, right? Also, let me know down in the comments below if you have any questions about Git integration, whether it's Azure DevOps or GitHub or whatever, let me know and I'll answer those as best as I can. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.